First of all, I'd like to say hello to all of my many friends, also to my many enemies. Once again, this is your friend, brother, and humble servant, Roosevelt, coming back at you with another episode of Roosevelt Sounds Off. I'd like to thank everybody for tuning into the program on today. And if you are not yet a subscriber to Roosevelt Sounds Off, please go down and hit the subscribe button along with the bell icon. This way you'll be notified anytime the next video drops. Before I get into today's video, I would like to send a big super shout out to my latest subscriber, Pastor Sanders. She is going to be my uncle's chaplain while he's in the nursing home. And we talked and everything for quite a while. Very, very nice lady who's a pastor and also a chaplain. And she's my latest subscriber and, you know, watching some of my older content. So I appreciate that. So you know how I do. If I know you and you know you just subscribe to the channel, you know I'll always send you a big thanks and a super shout out for doing so. It's my goal to soon get to 400 subscribers, because when I do have a special surprise for all of you. Okay, I am so happy and thankful for another day, and thankful for all of you who choose to tune in and watch me whenever you happen to be watching from, you know, your home, from your, you know, in your car on this Friday, you know, last day of the week and everything, TGIF, you know, and hopefully you're getting ready for a nice weekend. We're going to have a nice one here in Chicago, only it's going to be a scorcher. So with that out of the way, I'd like to get into today's video, and you see the title. Lori Lightfoot threatens us. Oh yeah, she did threaten us. What I mean by that is that, you know, because of this COVID-19 coronavirus plandemic, not pandemic, plandemic, you know, some of you all might get that later. And here in Illinois, we have been doing, I guess, very well as far as our numbers, because our numbers and everything are going down. But just because we had a couple of days where our numbers have gone up, she has now threatened to take us from phase 4 back to phase 3. Now, under phase 3, you know, we didn't have access to any parks. We didn't have any access to the lakefront. And if you did go to a restaurant, you had to do outdoor dining. Bars and other kind of so-called non-essential businesses were closed. She's threatening to take us back. So right now, I'm going to play a little bit of a press conference she had yesterday. And you're going to hear the threat. So I'm going to play like a little bit of that, and I'm going to come right back with you and tell you exactly what I think. Stay tuned for this clip.
Since the very beginning of this health crisis, we have been committed to tackling COVID-19 head on with a disciplined, data-driven approach. And we've seen how that manifests itself in a number of things that we've done to keep Chicagoans safe, including our racial equity rapid response team. And most recently, our rollout of COVID-19 Recovery Task Force report. Today, we're coming before the public because we want to make sure that we are alerting you to vital information before we have to take any specific action. We believe that providing the public with additional information, more information, highlighting the information that's out there will provide individuals with the tools that they need to do their part to make sure that we all continue to keep Chicago safe before we have to take any additional steps. Right now, our priority is keeping the numbers of new cases as low as possible, especially among our young people. Caring for and saving the lives of those who are sick, and doing everything in our power to stop the spread of this disease. Make no mistake, every single decision that we've made, really going back to March, so for 4+ months, has been difficult. It's not been easy. But we've been guided by the public health metrics, and we will continue to make the decisions that we believe are necessary to keep Chicagoans safe. I want to take this moment to thank all of you out there who have been staying home when able, socially distancing, wearing face coverings in public, and complying with the city and state guidelines. Your sacrifice, your adherence to the public health guidelines, truly has saved lives of your fellow Chicagoans. Make no mistake about that. You are the reason that everyone has the ability to have some semblance of a normal life because of the hard work that you have done every day since this pandemic hit Chicago. And on behalf of your fellow Chicagoans, I want to say thank you, and please keep up the great work. Unfortunately, there remain some of you who are still not getting the very clear messages we have been sending now for months. So hear this. Despite the fact that the weather might be warm, COVID-19 is still here in Chicago and will be part of our future for the foreseeable future. Yes, our metrics are tracking better than the rest of the country, but that doesn't mean that we can ever let our guard down. It means our precautions are working and that we need to continue to be diligent. And I want to specifically address some of the younger people in our city, the 18 to 29-year-old cohort. Folks, you are not immune to COVID-19. The reality is actually quite different, and the data proves it. Unfortunately, since June 15th, nearly 30% of the new cases in Chicago have come from those who are 18 to 29. And we're seeing these increases across race and ethnicity and all over the city. And this should be the proof that you need. If you are in the 18 to 29-year-old cohort, you are catching COVID-19. You are getting sick. And you're not only putting yourself at risk, you're putting every single person that you come into contact with at risk as well. So what can you do right now, 18 to 29-year-old Chicagoans? What can you do to turn this around? Number one, minimize gathering in large groups. I repeat, the larger the group, the higher the risk that someone in that group has COVID-19. So minimize gathering in large groups. Number two, wear a face covering when you leave your house. Everywhere. Not just some of the time, but all of the time. That's critically important to reduce the spread. And number three, spread the word, not the disease. What I mean by that is you need to be an ambassador for the public health guidance. Tell everyone in your network, tell your family members, tell your friends that if they do the things that you should be doing, which is minimize gathering in large groups, wear a face covering everywhere, social distance at all times, follow the hand hygiene guidance. If you spread that word, you will be not only protecting yourself, but your family, your friends, and everybody in your network that you care about. Let these numbers be yet another reminder that we have to do the right thing in this moment. Some of you have joked that I'm like the mom who will tear in the car around when you're acting up. No, friends, it's actually worse. I won't just turn the car around. I'm going to shut it off. I'm going to kick you out, and I'm going to make you walk home. That's who I am. That's who I must be for you and everyone else in the city to make sure that we continue to be safe. But I don't want to be that person if I don't have to. But I will if you make me. And right now, we are on the precipice. We are dangerously close to going back to a dangerous state of conditions, and Dr. Arty will talk about that in a moment. So, folks, we got to get this right. We got to continue to do the right things. If you are a business, we're not afraid to shut you down, and we've proven that. So please step up and do the right thing. follow the guidance that you know is in place to keep your workers, to keep your customers, and to keep you safe. This should go without saying, but I'm going to say it anyway. This vicious disease has already taken millions of lives around the world. And unfortunately, we're seeing the consequences of that every single day. We do not want to be like other parts of the country that are now straining under the burden of new cases and having their healthcare systems on the verge of collapse. We fear that in Chicago in March, but we avoided that because each of you who has done the right thing understood the necessity of the moment, the sacrifices that needed to be made to make sure that we were all going in the same direction to keep Chicago safe. Now, having been through this experience, the last thing I want to do is have to take steps back. I certainly don't want to be like other places in the country where we're shutting down commerce and business again. We fully recognize the hardship that this has placed on everyone. But if we must, we must. And it depends upon each and every person to do the right thing. Because the problem isn't just that you're hurting yourself. The problem isn't just that you're hurting people in your network. You're hurting the whole city. If we continue to see this uptick in cases, we're going to have no choice but to go back into phase three. That means shutting businesses down. That means imposing more restrictions on your mobility. No one wants to go back there. But we will have to go back there if people continue to ignore the public health.
And yes, we are back, and all of that falls under the category of fair use. Okay, let's get more into this. Not going to be before you too long. I just have to give my opinion here. Because in this whole, or during, should I say, this whole crisis that we are in, I think that many people, this is just my analysis, because if I feel this way, of course, you know, I'm just bold enough and big enough and bad enough to say it. But many other people are not. Because it just seems like with this particular issue, the public, or let's just say, you know, the mainstream public who goes around ingesting mainstream media, watching CNN all day, listening to what these lying politicians say, you know, they have a complete, you know, different way of thought than how I look at it. But, you know, us, you know, who are in, you know, this alternative media and who research and who look at other things besides CNN and the mainstream media, have a whole different opinion about what is going on. And it seems like in this whole pandemic, no one, they don't want anyone to disagree with what the mainstream media is saying. If you are one person who thinks like me, who wants to have independent thought, when it comes down to the mainstream media and your opinions about this whole coronavirus, COVID-19, differs from the mainstream media, everybody acts like you are the bad guy. Because many people tell me all the time, well, Roosevelt, instead of just talking about it and talking about the politicians and everything, I mean, just be quiet and stop complaining and just do what they say. Yeah, I hear you. You go ahead and you say do what they say. But it's hard to go along with something. It's hard to follow instructions whenever you are not quite clear on why you are doing it. What I mean by that is, you know, there were, I feel, were many lies told in the beginning, just like it's been many lies told right now about this whole thing. And it's just many of us out here that, you know, it's, you know, we try to be careful and everything with our lives and all of that kind of stuff. But after a while, you know, you just get to start thinking that people are just bullcrapping you after a while. You know, telling us to stay in and closing down non-essential businesses. And now, under phase four, all the restaurants and everything are back open and everything. You know, you can have in-person dining. you know, they can't fill it up. I think that you can only have like a 25% seating capacity. I mean, but if she makes good on her threat and goes back to phase three, some of these businesses said they would have to close down again because it hurt them to have to close down the first time when this whole thing began in March. But these businesses would be hurt and perhaps never come back if she decides to take us back to phase three. I don't understand what it is that she is trying to prove. But then, you know, I have another friend of mine who tells me, well, she feels that maybe she has to be a little bit hard because she's black and she's a woman and she's gay and, you know, she feels that people won't listen to her. You know, that's almost as stupid as me saying, I'm gonna go and act like a complete and total ass all because I'm visually impaired. Because if that's the case, she shouldn't even be taking on the job. Whatever you feel personally about your color, your gender, or your sexual preference, leave that stuff at home. Because if she ends up taking us back to phase three, and these businesses close up again, you know, people like her and Governor Pritzker, they don't give a crap. Because she is still going to make her entire salary as mayor of Chicago regardless. Pritzker is still going to make his governor's salary regardless. And even if he doesn't, a friend of mine looked it up yesterday about J.B. Pritzker. He himself is worth $3.1 billion. And his family, one of the richest, the Pritzker family, one of the richest families in the world, is worth over $33 billion. So, you know, they don't give a crap about the average, you know, bar owner who might have to shut down a business and lose money. They don't give a crap about the restaurant owner who has to shut down and lose money. They just don't care because their way is already made. So it's easy for these people, these rich, highfalutin people, to go and bark out orders because they don't have to suffer at the end of the day. They never do. They don't have to sacrifice anything. It's only us who are the little people that's making all the sacrifices, having to stay home, having our businesses suffer. I mean, I'm a small business owner myself. I take pictures, I do photography. I didn't have a prom season this year. I didn't have a wedding season this year. They don't care. They do not care. I think, really, really, I really believe that this whole thing was planned just to collapse the economy. Because, you know, this one of our presidents, I believe it was Franklin Delano Roosevelt, who says that nothing in our country and nothing in politics happens by coincidence. Everything is planned and very well strategically thought out. This whole thing, this whole pandemic was probably planned 20, 25, 30 years before. And it's quite strange that it would take place in 2020 during an election year. Some of you all might get that later. And Lori Lightfoot has just had her foot on our neck, even refusing to open up our beaches and pools. And as many people, like I was looking on the news today, and it's somebody, you know, with the pools and the beaches not being open, there are no lifeguards on duty. And so today there was somebody who actually drowned in the lake because they couldn't be rescued because there were no lifeguards. Because I guess certain people, because it is hot, and it's really going to be hot this weekend. We're talking about 96 degrees with a heat index of 105, they say. You actually really expect, if you want to use your darn brain, that people are not going to go against that order and go and get in the water anyway? People want to be free. People, we just want our lives back. Because she always says, because you know, Indiana and Wisconsin, they're much more open than what we are. And she and Governor Pritzker say one of their biggest fears is that, you know, a bunch of people are going to go to one of these free states and, you know, to participate in certain activities they can't access here in Chicago and bring back the dreaded corona. Ay, corona! People will just about do anything for freedom. That is why if you have to look at places or certain third world countries or communist countries like North Korea, There was a soldier who worked for the North Korean government who wanted to be free so bad. When he got to the border of South Korea, he just started running to get to the other side. He ended up getting himself shot. But he was trying to run to the South Korean side where it was free. So people will go anywhere and do anything for freedom. Now, I am not trying to say don't protect yourself. Don't, you know, be careful. Because even though I have my theories about this whole pandemic, really and truly, I know it's got to be something that is going on out there, because I know a number of people have passed away. But at the same time, I don't believe it is as many as they say. And I really believe just the actions of Lori Lightfoot, how she just acts plain unprofessional, how she gets on TV and yells and screams and has called people stupid and everything, tells us not to gather. But, you know, let me show you how she contradicts herself. When there were protests after the killing of George Floyd, she encouraged everybody to gather in peaceful protest. Then you didn't hear anything about her spouting about off about coronavirus then. And after that, there was loot rioting and looting and everything here in Chicago. She went on TV in a special report to put Chicago under martial law. But yet, when she get ready to lift it, she only lifted it via tweet. So, you know, I had a friend of mine call me, ask me, are we out from under the curfew yet? Because certain people didn't know. Because to me, if you're going to make a big deal about putting people under martial law and under a curfew, make a big of a deal about it when you get ready to release them. And a friend of mine's father, he actually accused me of having bias and talking against Lori Lightfoot all because she's black or she's a woman or she's gay. No, I could disagree with a person's policies and procedures without bringing those three elements into it. As far as her being a woman or black and everything is concerned, I mean, nobody cares about that and her being gay, but dude, nobody cares if you're gay or not, golly. Whatever kind of secret little stuff you want to do in your own bedroom, my God, that's in between you, number one, the person you do it with, number two, and God. You know, I'm not there or whatever watching. I'm not looking down on anybody getting a jolly so they rocks off and everything. That's completely on you, whatever you choose to do. You know, no, it's the policies and behavior and unprofessionalism that I agree with, and the threats to take us back to phase three. You heard what she said. Because, you know, I like to bring these receipts because I love to use people's own words against them. Where she says that she's not the kind of mother who would just turn the car around if people were misbehaving. She's the kind of mother who would cut off the car, kick you out, and make you walk home. What kind of stupid example and behavior is this from the mayor of the city of Chicago? People want to be free. We want our lives back. I can understand certain people have passed away, but what about us who are still living? What about us who still have to deal with this mentally and financially long after this pandemic is over? It's gonna be many people to suffer for years to come because of this thing, but Pritzker's not addressing this. Lori Lightfoot's not addressing this. They're only talking about the here and now. Why? Because they do not give a crap. They really don't. So, whether she takes us back to phase three, I guess it is remains to be seen. So at this point, that's where I'm gonna leave this video. If anybody liked this video, please do me a favor, give me a thumbs up, I greatly appreciate it. And tune in next time for another episode of Roosevelt Sounds Off, and until the next video, this has been your friend, brother and humble servant Roosevelt, saying peace and blessings to all of you and your families.